Hello students, welcome to the video tutorials of trigonometry. In this video, we will learn about periodic function, periods of trigonometric functions, domain and range of trigonometric functions, and graphs of trigonometric functions. And we will learn few transformations of graphs. Okay? First, what is a periodic function? See, a periodic function is a function which repeats itself after a certain interval of time. Okay, let us say for example, let us first take the definition of periodic function. Let us say we have function f of x. Okay, and if f of x plus some value p again gives us f of x. Okay, if f of x plus p is equal to f of x, we say f of x is a periodic function. Okay, and this p is the period. P is the period of this function f of x. Okay, see, f of x is a function. Okay, and in place of x, if you substitute x plus p and if you still get f of x is called as the periodic function, and p is the period of this function. Okay, let us take one example. Let us take sine. Okay, f of x is equal to sine x. Alright. Now, in place of this x, if we substitute x plus, let us say 2 pi, here p value is pi. X plus p value is 2 pi here. So this will be equal to how much? It will be sine x plus 2 pi. We can write x plus 2 pi as 2 pi plus x, right? What is 2 pi? It is 360 degrees. See, we have studied in the previous videos, this is 0 degrees, 90 degrees, 180, 270 and 360 again, right? So it is one complete circle, 360, right? So 360 and 0 degrees is one and the same. So we can write this as sine x by eliminating 2 pi, right? So what do we have now? We have f of x plus 2 pi is equal to sine x, which is again equal to f of x only, right? So f of x plus 2 pi is equal to f of x. Can we say this sine x is a periodic function? Yes, it is a periodic function. Okay, what will be the period of this function? It will be 2 pi. What did we substitute in place of p? We substituted 2 pi. Okay, so 2 pi is the period and sine x is the periodic function. Okay, in place of 2 pi, if we substitute 4 pi, see, in place of this, if we substitute 4 pi, 4 pi is equal to how much? It is equal to 360 and 360. Okay, 720, right? So 360 once, 360 twice will again give us 0 degrees. Okay, so this 4 pi will again give us sine x only, right? See, this 4 pi plus x will again give us sine x, right? So f of x plus 4 pi is f of x again. See, sine x plus 4 pi or 4 pi plus x is equal to sine x again. Now, what is the period now? Period is 4x. See, first we had 2 pi. Sorry, period is 4 pi now, right? Like this, once, twice, right? Okay, now can we take 6 pi? What will happen if you take 6 pi here? We'll get sine x again. Okay, 6 pi is also a period, 8 pi is also a period, 10 pi is also a period, and so on. Okay, yes, all these are periods of sine x function. Okay, but when we find period, when we talk about period, we generally talk about the smallest value of p. See, all these are values of p, right? The smallest value is 2 pi. 2 pi. we generally talk about the smallest period. So period is 2 pi and this period is called as fundamental period, main period, fundamental period. Okay. So when you are supposed to find the value of x, sorry, period of x, see all these are periods, but we take only the fundamental period of x, which is 2 pi. Alright. So I hope you understood what is a periodic function. Okay. So in that process, we have also learned the period of sine x. Alright. Now let us learn the period of cos x. Let me rub this. The period of cos x will also be equal to 2 pi because the values of cos will repeat. Okay. See, before studying about cos x, let us draw the graph of sin x. Okay. This is our x axis and this is y axis. If you draw the graphs, it will be more clear. We'll take radians on x, 0, and here pi by 2, here 2 pi by 2. 2 pi by 2 is same as pi. 2 and 2 will get cancelled. And here let us take 3 pi by 2, and this is 4 pi by 2, 5 pi by 2, 6 pi by 2, okay, 7 pi by 2, and 8 pi by 2. Alright, let me look this part. Now, see, sine 0 is 0, right? So, this, we are drawing the graph of sine x in place of x, 0, okay? Okay, what is sine pi by 2? Sine 90, sine 90 is 1, right? So, this will be 1. Let us take this is 1. Here, x, sorry, y value is plus 1 and let us take minus 1 here. Let us draw a dotted line. This is minus 1. Okay. Alright. What will be sine pi? Sine pi is 180, right? 180 is again 0. Okay. So, this will be 0. So, what happened here? See, value of sine x increased. Okay, the maximum was plus 1. After pi by 2, if we increase the angle, what is happening? The value is decreasing again. Right? The value is decreasing again. See, sine 0, 30, 45, 60 and 90, right? What is this? 0, 1 by 2, 1 by root 2, root 3 by 2 and 1. So, sine 0 is 0, sine 90 is 1. Okay, sine 90 is plus 1. All other values will lie between this 0 and 1. All these values are lying between 0 and 1. Right? 1 by 2 is how much? 0.5. Okay, so if you have 30 degrees here, this is 1 by 2. How much is this? 1 by root 2. We cannot divide it, right? So let us rationalize, this will be root 2 divided by 2, root 2 into root 2 is this, we know root 2 is 1.414 divided by 2, this will give us 0.707. So it is greater than 0.5. So what is happening? The values are increasing, right? Root 3 by 2, root 3 is 1.732 divided by 2, so this will be equal to 0.8 something, right? So this is 0.7, now this is 0.8. The values of sine are increasing. So they will increase till 90 degrees, till here, and then they will decrease again. Okay. Alright. Why will they decrease? Because 120, sine 120 will be root 3 by 2. Okay. Sine 135 will be 1 by root 2. Okay. And so on. Okay. From here to here increasing and again decreasing. So that's why we have a graph like this. Now, what will happen after pi? See, after pi, see, angle will lie in the third quadrant. In the third quadrant, sine value is negative, right? So the values will be decreasing. Okay, they will decrease till minus 1. Okay, this 3 pi by 2 is equal to 270 actually, right? And what will happen here again? The values will increase from minus 1 to 0 again. Okay, like this. So we have one wave. Okay, now after this 2 pi, the values are repeated. See, the same values will be repeated to here. Okay, and here this is minus 1 and plus 1, sorry, 0 here, right? So what is happening here? See, up to here it is having one form, right? And again it is starting the same pattern again, the same pattern again, right? See, here, from here to here, we have the same thing, same values. And again from 2 pi, we are having the same values. So, sine is a periodic function. What did we learn? What is a periodic function? What is the definition of periodic function? Periodic function is a function which repeats itself after certain time period, right? Or after certain interval. Okay? Alright, so sine x is a periodic function. Okay, just now we have studied that using this x plus 2 pi is equal to sine x. Now, what is the period? See, what is the period from here to here? Okay, it is 2 pi. It is repeating the values again. So, this is 2 pi, this is 2 pi, 2 pi, 2 pi, right? The values will be repeated for every 2 pi. So, 2 pi is the period of sine x. Alright? I hope this is clear. And what else can we learn in sine graph? The domain. Domain and range. Okay? Now, what are domains? See? Domain and range of sine x. See, domain is the input value we give. So, can we give any value for x here? Can we give 0? Can we give 1, 2, 3, 4, 90 and so on? Yes, can we give negative values also? Yes, if we give negative values, the graph will be like this, right? Same thing, it will repeat 2 pi, 2 pi, 2 pi, same thing, right? So, can we give any value in place of x? Can we give the input any value x? Yes. So that is real numbers. Okay. Domain will be R, which means we can give any real number in place of x. We can write any real number. The sine will accept any real number. Okay. And it will give us some output. Right. That output given by sine is range. Okay. See, what is domain? Domain is the input values we give. What is range? Range is the output values we get. Okay. Now, no matter what values of x we give here. Let us say x is equal to 0, 90, 180. Okay. Anything. You give any value of x. Minus 90, minus 180. You give any value of x. The values will be from minus 1 to plus 1 only. Okay. See, sine graph is not going beyond plus x, not going above plus x, and not going below minus x, right? Which means the maximum value sine can take is plus 1. The minimum value sine will take or will give us is minus 1. Okay. So the outputs will lie between minus 1 to plus 1 only, right? Minus 1 to plus 1, including minus 1 and plus 1. This square brackets implies that minus 1 and plus 1 are included. If we have like this, which means minus 1 and plus 1 are excluded, they are not included. Right? But here we'll get plus 1 and minus 1 also. Okay, so this is the range. Range is the real numbers, and domain is the real numbers, and range is minus 1 to plus 1. Alright. us learn the transformations of sine graph now.
Okay.
We have different forms in sine. Okay. See, this is sine x graph, right? We have studied just now that this is sine x graph. What if we have something like sine x plus xc, sine x plus a? These two are different. We have sine x plus a and sine x plus a. These two are different. Okay. We will study about these different types of graphs now. Alright. Now, see, this is sine x graph. What will happen if we have this sine x plus a? See, in place of a, let us take some value. Let us take 2. Okay. So, let us try to draw the graph now. See, here we'll have 0, right? Here it will be pi by 2, 2 pi by 2, 3 pi by 2, 4 pi by 2, 5 pi by 2, 6 pi by 2, and so on. These are x values, right? Plus 1, minus 1. Okay. See, what will happen if you substitute x is equal to 0 here? See, these are all x values, right? Okay. What will happen if you substitute x is equal to 0? It will be sine 0 plus 2. Sine 0 is 0. Right, so 0 plus 2 will be equal to 0. So, sorry, 0 plus 2 is equal to 2. Now, if x is equal to 0, this is giving us 2, right? So, this is plus 2. So, the first point will be here. Okay, alright. Let us now take 90. See, we are taking the known values, right? So, 90 is 1. Sine 90 is 1, so 1 plus 2 will be equal to 3. Alright. So, when 90, that is pi by 2, this value is equal to how much? It is equal to plus 3. Okay. This is plus 3. The maximum value it can take now is 3. Alright. The maximum value it will be is equal to 3. What could be the minimum value? See, if you write 270 here, it will be minus 1, right? Minus 1 plus 2 will be plus 1. Okay. So, the minimum value will be equal to how much? See, it will be 0 again at 180. If you take 180, sine 180 plus 2, this is 0. 0 plus 2 will be again equal to 2, right? So, the graph will go up. It will come down. Alright. And at 3 pi by 2. See, it will be minimum. It will be plus 1. Okay. At sine 270 plus 2, this will be minus 1 plus 2, it will be equal to 1. Okay. Again, at this. Sorry, this one. Okay. Now see, we have one curve. After this, the values will repeat again, right? The values will repeat again. So, the period is same. The period is 2 pi. 4 pi by 2 is how much? It is 2 pi, right? But if you observe carefully, what happened to the graph here? See, this is sine x plus 2 graph. See, it is the exact same graph, but the graph is above now, right? Isn't it? See, initially it was here, plus 1 to minus 1. Now, the graph got shifted slightly higher. Okay. So, if you have something like this, sine x plus a, the graph will be shifted up. Alright. If we have sine x minus a, the graph will be below this x-axis. Exactly same, but below the x-axis. Right. Because we'll have minus 2 here. If you take 2, this will be minus 2, right? Okay, so 0 minus 2 will be minus 2, here, minus 1, right? Okay, here, minus 2, so this will be minus 3, alright? So, the values will be minus 2, minus 1, minus 3. It will start from minus 2, minus 2 is here, minus 3. we are taking this graph now, sine x minus 2. The values will be minus 2 at 0. So at 0 it will be minus 2. At 90, minus 1, right? At 90, minus 1, okay? And this one is 0, minus 2, again minus 2, right? So again minus 2 here at pi, okay? Again, at 3 pi by 2, it will be minus 3. This is minus 3. Again, at 4 pi by 2, it will be equal to 0. And the values will repeat again. Okay? So, see here. This much is 2 pi. So, we have the exact same graph. But if you have sine x minus 2, the graph is shifted below x. Okay? The graph is shifted here, below. It was originally here. It was between plus 1, minus 1. Now it has been shifted down. Right? If we have sine x plus 2, the graph will be shifted up. Okay? I hope you understood this. The period will remain same. It will remain 2 pi only. Okay? The period will remain same. It will be 2 pi. So, these two are done. Okay? Let me rub the board and let us check this two now.
Okay.
Let us learn about sine x plus a and sine x minus a. Okay. Now, see, if you have x plus a, sine x plus a will have the exact same graph, but it will be shifted to the left side, slightly to the left. Okay. See, plus a, it will be shifted to the left side. Minus a, it will be shifted to the right side. Okay. This you will learn in oscillations of physics also. Periodic functions, oscillations, simple harmonic motions, etc. Right? So, let us learn about sine x plus a. See, let us say this is sine x graph, right? Let us draw the graph here only. Sine x plus a. In place of x, let us take x plus 2. Okay? In place of a, we are taking 2. So, if we substitute 0, it will be sine 2, right? Sine 2 degrees will have some value for sine 2, right? Okay. So, sine 0, if you take x is equal to 0, okay, will have some value. That means, maybe somewhere here. I hope you are able to see this. Okay, sine 2 will be something, right? So, on y-axis, we have drawn that. Okay. Let us take 28 degrees, 28, x is equal to 28 we took now, so this will be sine 30, sine 30 is 1 by 2, 0.5, right? So, 30 will be somewhere here, 0.5 will be somewhere here now, okay? Now, if you take x as, let us take 88, because 88 plus 2, right? 88 plus 2 will give us sine 90, sine 90 is equal to 1. But see here, see sine 90 is 1, but what is x value? 88 degrees. So these are all x values, right? So at 88, see 88 may be somewhere here. Here x value is 88 and y value is how much? It is equal to 1. So the graph will be like this, shifted slightly to the right side. Okay? If you go on finding the values, it will be shifted slightly to the right side. I hope you are able to understand the difference. Okay. So what happened here? If x plus some number, x plus a, if we have sine x plus a, the graph is shifted to the right slightly. Okay. Similarly, if we have sine x minus a, the graph will be shifted to the right side. Okay. Of course, the period will still be 2 pi only. What is period? Okay. What is period? After what interval the values are repeated? Right? So, see, from here, if you check, the values are repeated here again. Right? So, this will still be 2 pi only. Okay. It will still be equal to 2 pi. I hope this is clear. So, this, you can draw this, x minus a, okay? you can take 0 minus 2, you will get sine minus sine 2 will have some negative values, right? Okay, or you can take 32 degrees here, you can take 32 minus 2 will be equal to sine 30. Okay, so the point will be here now. The next point will be here. Okay, it will be here. So we'll have a graph like this. This will be the graph slightly ahead. Okay, period will still be 2 pi only. I hope this is clear. Please remember that if you have sine x plus a, the graph will be shifted to the left side. If it is sine x minus a, the graph will be shifted to the right side slightly. Okay, what about sine ax? Let us learn about sine ax. See, sine ax, the graph will be higher, the peaks will be higher now.
I'll rub this and do it again. Okay,
let us learn about sine ax graph. This is sine x. This is sine x graph. Maximum value plus 1, minimum value minus 1, right? Okay. Now, what will be sine ax? See, in place of a, if you take some 2, it will be 2x, right? So, sine, if you take x is equal to 0, okay? This will be sine 2 into 0, sine 0. Sine 0 is 0, right? So, point will be here. Okay, if you take x is equal to 90 or if you take x is equal to 45, let us take 45. So we'll have 2 into 45 here. This will be equal to sine 90. It will be equal to 1, right? So here, 45 degrees will be here, right? Pi by 4 will be here. So here at pi by 4, it has reached maximum value, right? It has reached maximum value at pi by 4. Okay. Which is plus 1, right? Yes. If you take 90, x is equal to 90, 2 into 90, this will be sine 180. Okay, what is sine 180? It is equal to 0. So at 90, it is 0 again. Okay. So this will be the graph now, right? At, see, pi by 4, 2 pi by 4, at 3 pi by 4, here it will be minus 1, and here at pi it will be plus 1 here again. So see here. So initially for sine x, from 0 to 2 pi by 2, we had only half of this, right? Okay, but here we have complete one wave, and again we'll have one more wave here. In this, the values are repeating now, right? The values are repeating after every pi. So see, 2 pi by 2 is equal to pi only, right? So from here to here it is pi, right? So from here to here it is pi, from here to here it is pi, right? From here to here it is pi. So they will keep on repeating. These values will repeat. This graph will repeat, right? For every pi value, this graph will repeat. Okay. Now, what is the period of this sine ax function or sine 2x? What is the period of sine 2x? It is equal to pi. Okay. See? Period of sine 2x is pi. We learned one important thing here. See, what was period of sine x? Period of sine x was 2 pi. Okay. Alright. What is period of 2x? This 2 pi got divided by 2. Whatever number we have here, it will be divided by that number, and we have pi here. Okay. Similarly, the period of sine 3x will be equal to 2 pi by 3. Okay. Because see, the period of sine x is 2 pi, we should take this number and divide. Okay, 2 pi by 3. Divide here. So this is 2 pi only, this will be 2 pi by 3. What will be period of 4x? Take period of x, divide by 4. So this will be pi by 2. Okay, one important concept we have studied here about the period. Okay, what will happen to this sine 2x? See, this will be compressed. Okay, I told the peaks will be higher, right? I was wrong, sorry. The graph will be compressed. Alright, and the period will be half. That will become pi. Okay, for 2x, sine 2x, the period is pi. I hope this is clear. Now, what will happen to this x by a? The graph will be expanded. We'll see that. Okay, let us study about sine x by a graph. This is sine x graph. Okay, this is sine x graph. Maximum value is plus 1, minimum value is minus 1. Okay, and the period is 2 pi. Okay, let us see what will happen to sine x by a. Alright, now see here. If you take the value of x as 0, so this will be 0 by a, okay, it will be equal to 0, sine 0 is 0. So this is the point now, alright. Now, if you take x as pi by 2, so this will be pi by 2, let us take this as 2, x by 2, okay, so divided by 2, this will be sine pi by 4, sine pi by 4 is equal to 1 by root 2, right? So this will be 1 by root 2 multiplied by root 2 by root 2, we are rationalizing, so this will be root 2 by 2, this will be 1.414 by 2, approximately 0.707, okay, somewhere here, alright. If you take x is equal to pi, so we have sine pi by 2 now. Sine pi by 2 is equal to how much? It is sine 90, it will be equal to 1. Okay, so sine, see here, it is pi. 2 pi by 2 is pi, right? So this will reach maximum at pi. Okay, so we have a graph like this. Alright, okay, and it will become 0 at 4 pi by 2 again. See, it has reached only half, right, maximum. Now, to come down, it will be like this. Okay, this is a curve, alright, and again, point here, okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, we'll have like this. See what happened? See, we have one curve, sorry, one wave and two waves here, right? For sine x, we had two waves. But for sine x by 2, from here to here, we have only one wave. So the graph got expanded, right? Okay, enlarged or elongated. Isn't it? Graph got elongated. Now, what will be the period, see, from here to here? The values will repeat again, right? The period will be 8 pi by 2, which is equal to 4 pi. So, it is similar to the previous one. If we had sine x, the period was 2 pi. If we had 2x, the period was 2 pi divided by this, right? So, it would have been pi. If it is sine x by 2, we should take 2 pi and then divide by 1 by 2 only, right? It is 1 by 2. So this will in fact be equal to 4 pi. Okay. I hope this is clear. The period will be 4 pi and the graph will be elongated. Alright. Now what about sine x? Let us learn about modulus of sine x. Okay. Okay. Let us learn about modulus of sine x graph. Say this is sine x graph. Okay. Now, see, in modulus of sine x, we take only the magnitude, absolute value of x, sine x, which means we will not take the negative values. Even if it is negative, we will take it as positive value, right? So, see, these are the positive values of sine and these are negative values, but this negative values will not consider because we have a mod here, right? We will take the positive values again. Okay. So the graph will be like this. See, let me draw it separately. The graph of mod sine x will be like this. This should actually be negative, right? But since we have sine mod of sine x, this will also be positive, right? Positive, positive, and it will repeat. Okay. Now, this is 0, this is pi by 2, this is 2 pi by 2, which is equal to pi only, right? And this is 3 pi by 2, and this is 4 pi by 2. Now, if you observe carefully, see, this function, this modulus of sine x function is repeating after pi, right? See, this is 1 pi, this is another pi, and third pi, and fourth pi, right? So, what is the period of this function now? It is equal to pi, because it is repeating after every pi, right? So, I hope this is clear. So, we have studied about all these variations of sine graphs. Now, we will study about the remaining trigonometric functions, okay? We will study about cos, tan, cosecant, secant, and cot, okay? Range and domains also of this, and periods also of those trigonometric functions. Okay, let us learn about cos now. So, see, let us take x is equal to 0. Cos 0 is equal to 1, right? So, at when x is equal to 0, cos is plus 1. Okay, let us say this line represents y is equal to plus 1, alright, and this line represents y is equal to minus 1. Alright, so here, okay, what is cos 90? If you take x is equal to 90, 90 we know cos 90 is equal to 0, right? So here, alright, what is cos 180? That is 2 pi. It is minus 1, right? So it will be minus 1. So we'll have a graph like this, okay? And 3 pi by 2 will be 0 again, and 4 pi by 2 will be 1 again, okay? Because 4 pi by 2 is actually 2 pi. 2 pi is 360 degrees, it is 0 degrees, right? Okay. So the curve will repeat again, right? Like this. What will be the period? See, from here to here. Okay? This. Okay? It will repeat again. Right? So, what is the period of cos x now? It is 2 pi. 4 pi by 2 is equal to 2 pi only, right? So, period is 2 pi. Okay. I hope this is clear. Okay, so this is cos x graph. Okay, it will also look like sine x graph only, but it will start from here. Okay, because at x is equal to 0, cos 0 is plus 1, right? Whereas sine graph will start from here, it will be like this. What about the domain and the range? Let me just run this sine graph. What about the domain and the range? What is domain? Domain values are the values which we give, right? Input values. So here, in place of x, can we substitute any value? Do you find any break in this? See? There is no break in this graph, right? Which means we can substitute any values of x. In place of x, we can substitute anything. Okay, here also we can substitute anything. Right? See, we can substitute 0, we can substitute 90, we can substitute 180, we can substitute minus 90, we can substitute minus 180, anything we like. Right? So, range of cos x is, sorry, domain of cos x is real numbers. So, we can substitute any value, right? What is range now? Range is the output it gives, right? inputs, we can substitute anything in place of x, right? But what will be the outputs? No matter what values of x we substitute, the outputs will always be from plus 1 to minus 1 or from minus 1 to plus 1, right? So the range will be from minus 1 to plus 1, including minus 1 and plus 1. That's why we have square brackets here. So sine and cos are exactly same, right? Sine period is 2 pi, cos period is also 2 pi. Domain is our range. Domain of cos x is also our range. Of sine x is minus 1, 1. Range of cos x is also minus 1 and 1. Okay. I hope this is clear. Now let us study the reciprocals of sine and cos graph. See, reciprocal of sine graph, sine is cosecant, right? So we'll study about this, and reciprocal of cos is secant. Okay. Tan and cot we'll study afterwards. Okay. Let us study about cosecant graph now. See, to understand cosecant graph, we should know what is sine graph. We have studied about sine graph just now, right? This is sine graph. Okay. And sine and cosecant are reciprocal to each other, which means if sine is decreasing, cosecant should increase, reciprocal, reverse, right? And if sine is increasing, cosecant should decrease. Okay. So we know cosecant values will be this. Cosecant 0 is not defined because this sine 0 is how much? 0. Cosecant 0 will be reciprocal of 0. Reciprocal of 0 will be 1 by 0, which will be not defined, right? And sine pi by 2 is equal to 1. So cosecant pi by 2 will be reciprocal of 1. Reciprocal of 1 is 1 only, right? So like this, we can find these values. So cosecant 0 is not defined, cosecant pi by 2 is 1, cosecant 2 pi by 2, which is cosecant pi, is equal to not defined, and 3 pi by 2 will be minus 1, and 4 pi by 2, which is 2 pi, is not defined again, right? Okay. See, if sine values are increasing, cosecant values should decrease, and if sine values are decreasing, cosecant values should increase. It should be the reverse. Let us use that logic here. Okay. That is, when sine value is 0, cosecant should be not defined. Not defined. Okay. Alright. Now, see, sine values are increasing from 0 to pi by 2. It will be increasing, right? So, cosecant value should decrease, right? Decrease till what? Pi by 2. Pi by 2 is 1. Okay, up to here. See? Increasing, decreasing. Decreasing from where? Decreasing from not defined. Decreasing from infinity. Right? That is, when sine is 0, cosecant should be infinity, right? So it is coming from infinity. This graph is coming from infinity. This graph is coming from 0. They are meeting here at 1. Okay? Because at cosecant pi by 2, cosecant pi by 2 is 1, sine pi by 2 is also 1. Okay, alright. What will happen now? See, it is decreasing now. So it should increase, right? It should increase. Okay, increase till what? Pi by 2. Sorry, increase till infinity. That is not defined, right? So let us draw a line here. These lines are called as asymptotes line. Asymptotes. Okay. Alright. So see, these lines will not touch the graph, but they will touch at infinity. Okay. Alright. So what will happen now? See, we have, I hope you are able to understand this. We have a graph like this. From 0 to pi. 2 pi by 2 is pi only, right? From 0 to pi, we have a graph like this. Okay. What will happen now? At 2 pi by 2, after 2 pi by 2, what will happen? See, from here, the values are decreasing. Okay, from negative. Okay. So, see, cosecant values will increase. They will come here. Okay. Let us take this much. These two lines will not meet each other. They will meet at infinity. Okay. All right. They'll come at minus 1. They'll meet at minus 1. And see, here sine values are increasing. From here to here, sine values are increasing, which means they'll decrease again. Cosecant value will decrease again, right? So, if you remove this sine graph, this one will be the cos graph. Okay? One parabola upside, one parabola downside. Okay? One parabola upside here. Okay? And one parabola downside here, like this. Okay? Now, what will be the period of this function? See, these are, this is actually cosecant graph now. To understand cosecant graph, we should understand sine graph, because cosecant and sine are reciprocal to each other, right? I hope you understood this. And these lines are called as asymptotes. What are asymptotes? See, I'll give you a brief introduction, brief definition of asymptote. See, asymptote is a tangent drawn to a curve at infinity. See, if you have a curve, let us say this is the curve, and if you want to draw a tangent, see, okay, this is a tangent. Now, how can we draw a tangent at infinity? See, this two lines will meet at infinity, right? So this will be an asymptote, that is a tangent drawn at infinity to this curve, right? Okay. So what is an asymptote? Asymptote is a tangent drawn to a curve from at infinity. Okay. So these lines are called as asymptotes. I hope this is clear. Okay. Now, see, this is 2 pi by 2. This is 4 pi by 2. 6 pi by 2. This is 8 pi by 2. What is the period? See, up to here it is one period. It is repeating again. One parabola up, one parabola down. Again one parabola up, one parabola down. So 4 pi by 2, which is actually equal to 2 pi. 2 pi will be the period of cosecant. So period of cosecant is also equal to 2 pi. What will be the domain now? See, can we give pi value 2 pi by 2? Can we give 2 pi by 2 as input? If we give this 2 pi by 2 as input, will have a not defined value, right? Okay, so the inputs cannot be this 2 pi by 2, okay, or this 0, or this 4 pi by 2, or 6 pi by 2, and 8 pi by 2, and so on, right? So how can we write this generally? Apart from these numbers, we can give anything we like, right? So this is actually equal to, see, what will be the domain of cosecant? R minus, that means R means any value except what? Except n pi by 2, right? N pi by 2, 4, okay? Can we take that as n pi by 2, where n is an odd number? Yes, okay? Or yes, you can take it as n pi. Yes, because see, 2 pi by 2 is how much? It is pi. This is 2 pi. Yes, this is 3 pi, this is 4 pi, and this is 0. Right? Yes. Asymptotes will be at 0, pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, and 4 pi, right? So we can generalize that and take it as n pi. So we can give input values, anything, real numbers except n pi. Right? Where n is 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. So this is r minus n pi. Okay? This is the domain of cosecant, r minus n pi. Okay? Now, what will be the range? See, what are the values? Values are from plus infinity, right? Values are from plus infinity to 1. Okay? Including 1. Plus infinity. Okay, see, for infinity we will not write this brackets. We will write, okay, round brackets. Plus infinity to 1 and minus infinity to minus 1. Okay. Okay, we'll not write this. See, actually, we'll write the minus values first. See, minus infinity to minus 1, like this. We'll start from minus infinity to minus 1, union 1 to plus infinity. Okay, this is the range. Okay, I don't think I can write here. Let me try. Minus infinity to minus 1 union 1 to plus infinity. Okay, let us learn about secant now. Let us study the graph of secant x. To understand secant x graph, we need cos x graph, right? This is cos x graph. Okay, few minutes ago we have studied this, right? And cos and secant are reciprocal to each other. Secant and cos are reciprocal, right? Okay, now, which means if cos is increasing, secant should decrease. Okay, and if secant is increasing, cos should decrease. The reverse, right? Okay, and we know these values. Secant 0 is 1, okay, because cos 0 is 1, the reciprocal of this cos 0 will be secant 0, okay, that will also be equal to 1, right? And cos pi by 2 is 0, so secant pi by 2 will be reciprocal of 0, that is 1 by 0, 1 by 0 will be not defined, like this, we can write this values, right? Okay, now, see, if cos is increasing, secant should decrease, alright, see? This is plus 1 and this is minus 1. Right? This line represents plus 1. This line represents minus 1. Okay. So, see here. Cos values are increasing. Okay. So, secant value should decrease. Right. So, if we draw a line here. Okay. They should decrease. They should decrease. From where? Where should these values come from? From infinity. Right. Okay. Okay. See. Cos is 0 and minus pi by 2. If it is 0, if cos is 0, secant should be infinity, right? There should come, this graph should come from infinity and meet here at plus 1. Okay. And again see, cos values are decreasing till pi by 2. Okay. So let us draw a line here. Now secant value should increase, right? And these two lines will not meet each other, they'll meet at infinity. Alright? Okay. Now, what about this negative values now? See? Values are decreasing. So, they should increase from negative, right? From negative, they should increase and they should come at minus 1. This graph should be at minus 1. Okay? If we draw an asymptote here, this will go down, right? Like this. Okay? Now, if we remove this cos graph, okay, alright, this is the secant graph, okay, let us draw asymptotes, okay, so here, and we'll have parabola opening upwards. Now, parabola opening downwards here like this, right? What will be the period of this function? This is secant x graph now. See, one parabola up, one parabola down. One parabola up, one parabola down. So, it is following the same pattern, right? From here to here and from here to here, it is the same pattern. It will repeat again. But still, see, how many? This is pi by 2, pi by 2, pi by 2, pi by 2. 4 pi by 2's will be 2 pi only. From here to here, it is still 2 pi. Okay? So, period is what? It is 2 pi. Period of secant is also same as period of cos, 2 pi. Okay? Now, what will be the range? Can it accept all the values like cos? No. See, we have asymptotes here, right? That means we should not take this values, we should not consider this values. What values are these? These are odd multiples of pi by 2. We have pi by 2, minus pi by 2, pi by 2, 3 pi by 2, 5 pi by 2, 7 pi by 2, 9 pi by 2 and so on, right? Odd multiples of pi by 2. Okay, we can take any value. Okay, we can take any real number except odd multiples of pi by 2. How can we generalize that? R minus odd number, we will write it like this, right? 2n plus 1, where n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. Okay, so the domain is R minus 2n plus 1 pi by 2. Okay, where n is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. See, if you substitute n is equal to 0, okay, this will be pi by 2. So pi by 2, we cannot take pi by 2 value, right? If you substitute n is equal to 1, so this will be 3. 3 pi by 2 also we cannot take. Okay. Alright. What about the range now? A range will be same as cosecant. See, it is starting from plus infinity, right? Plus infinity to plus 1. Okay. Union, including plus 1, right? So square brackets. Union minus infinity to minus 1. See, we generally write this in the reverse format. We write plus first, minus first, union 1 to infinity, like this. So the range is same as this. What is the range? Minus infinity to minus 1, union 1 to infinity. Okay, we have studied period, domain and range of sine, cos, cosecant and secant. Now let us study about tan and cot. Let us study about tan graph. Okay, see, tan 0 is 0, tan 45 is 1, tan 90 degrees is not defined, tan 135 is minus 1, because 135 will lie in the second quadrant and in the second quadrant tan is negative, right? Tan 180 is 0. Alright. Alright. Tan 180 is it 0 or is it not defined? We can take 90 plus 90, right? Alright. Tan will change to cot, so it is cot 90, it will be 0, right? Yes. I got confused there. Let us draw tan graph. This is y value, this is x value, right? 0, pi by 2, 2 pi by 2, 3 pi by 2, 4 pi by 2, 5 pi by 2, 6 pi by 2. And so on, and here minus pi by 2. Okay, see, at 90 degrees it is not defined, right? So let us draw asymptotes here. This is one asymptote and this is one asymptote. Okay, another one, and odd multiples of pi, right? Okay, odd multiples of pi. tan 0 is 0, right? Tan 90 is not defined. See, not defined. See, it will come like this, right? From 0 to 90, it is increasing. Alright? Okay. Now, see, if we go here on the left side of x values, what will happen? It will be like this. Okay? Because at minus 90, it is not defined, right? Okay. All right. So we'll have a graph like this. At pi, that is 2 pi by 2, it is pi, right? It is 180, it will be 0. Okay. Like this. Now, the graph will be like this. I hope you understood this graph. Okay. Now, what are the periods? What is the period? See, this is tan x graph. What is the period of this tan x? It is repeating, right? So from here to here, from here to here, from here to here, it is repeating, right? So how much is this minus pi by 2 to pi by 2? It is pi. See, from 0 to pi by 2, it is pi by 2, right? So this pi by 2 and this pi by 2 will give us pi, okay? So the period is pi. It is not 2 pi like we had for secant, cosecant, cos and sine. For tan, period is only pi, okay? What will be the value of domain now? See, where are the asymptotes? We cannot take this value, right? Odd multiples of pi, odd multiples of pi by 2. So we can take anything but odd multiples. Odd multiples we can write it as 2n plus 1 pi by 2, right? So the domain is r minus 2n plus 1 pi by 2, which is same as secant, okay? All right. What will be the values of tan? What will be the values of range now? See, minus infinity to plus infinity, right? Minus infinity to plus infinity. So the domain, so the range will be minus infinity to plus infinity, which means any number, right, which is equal to r only, right? Real number. Okay, I hope this is clear. So period is pi, domain is any number except odd multiples of pi by 2, and range is r. Okay.
Okay.
Let us study about chord graph. This is chord x graph. Okay. Okay. This is our x axis. This is y axis. And we know chord values. Chord 0 is not defined. Pi by 2 is not defined. Okay. We can write 45 also. Pi by 4. It will be equal to 1, right? Okay. 2 pi by 2, which is pi, not defined. 3 pi by 2 is 0. 4 pi by 2 is 2 pi, which is not defined, right? Okay. Now see, where we have chord not defined at 0, 2 pi by 2. So asymptotes will be at 0 and at 2 pi by 2 and 4 pi by 2 and 6 pi by 2, right? Which means asymptotes will be at pi, 2 pi, 3 pi. We cannot take this value, right? So in domain, we can omit these values, right? N pi, where n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. Okay? Alright, so let us write this domain r minus n pi. This is done. Okay? Let us find the period and range and let us draw the graph of chord. See, 0 not defined and pi by 4 is 1. So see, pi by 4 will be here. Okay, if 1 is here, this value will be here, right? So it is coming from plus infinity, right? It will be like this, plus infinity to, okay, 45 will be here and this is minus 0, pi by 2 is 0. Again, it will go like this, right? Graph is slightly wrong. It will be like this. Alright. It will not touch this asymptote. Okay. See, from pi by 2 to 2 pi by 2, which is pi, from pi by 2 to 2 pi by 2, chord values will be negative, right? Because in the second quadrant, chord are negative. Okay. So we have negative values here. And again, in the third quadrant, see, from 2 pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2 in the third quadrant, the values will be positive, right? Like this. Again, in the fourth quadrant, the values will be negative, like this. Okay? Again, like this and like this. We have a graph like this, right? Okay. Now, see, check the period. The graph is repeating after every pi value, right? Pi, pi, and pi. So period is pi, like tan, and we just checked, right, where are the asymptotes? At 0 and pi, 2 pi by 2, 4 pi by 2, 6 pi by 2. We should not take those values in the domain, right? So r minus n pi, where n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? Alright. What about the range now? Range will be same as 10, because see, plus infinity to minus infinity, right? Cot values can be anything. So, which means it is equal to r. Range is equal to r. Alright? I hope you all understood this. It was a lengthy video, but it's a very, very important video. Alright? We have studied about what are periodic functions, what is period of sine, domain and range of sine, and we have studied different transformations of sine. You can do different transformation of cos, cosecant, secant, tan and cot based on this concept only, right? And then we have studied about cos, secant, cosecant, tan and cot graphs, okay?